To Family Kitchen. In this video, we will be making egg fried rice. And for this recipe, you will be needing eggs, raisins, star, cardamom, cashew nut, onions, coriander, some thinly chopped boiled carrots with boiled sweet corn and peas, and then boiled rice. You can also use butter instead of the oil. First, we're going to add some butter, and we're just going to saute it for a while.
We are adding.
Now we're going to add some cardamom and star.
Can you speak loud, please?
We're going to stir the cardamom and the bar. To get some flavor in them. Next, we're going to add the onion. And just stir it for a while, okay? Now, for taste, we're going to add salt. That's an optional ingredient. You don't really need to add salt if you don't want to. It's for your taste. If you are going to use salt, you can use any amount. So, when the onion is cooking, you can add a lid over it to keep the steam and heat in it, in the pan. And take off and then stir for some time. Now we're going to crack the egg and we're going to just pour it in like that. We're going to use 4 eggs. You can use as many as you want, depending on how big your family is. After that, what we're going to do is just stir the eggs and the onions together, making like an omelette-y type of thing. Now you can see the texture is very different because of the egg. And what the egg has done. It's like a omelette and onion thing. You can use turmeric powder for more flavor and spice.
For color.
Yeah, for color as well. You can use a little bit of chili powder, or you can use
green chili if you like to. It can be chopped green chili, 4 or just a couple of them if you like to use. Then now I am going to add here vegetables. It's boiled and cool vegetable.
Yeah.
So
boiled,
I used it in here
corn and peas.
For the color, texture, multiple, you know, different situation. So while stirred well and kept for a couple of minutes over in the cooker.
Next step, we're gonna use some butter in a frying pan, okay? I'm just going to let that melt and saute with some onions. Not onions, sorry, raisins. Mm. And raisins. You're going to stir them. You can add a little bit of coriander as well. So as you can see, we're just sauteing the butter and the raisins. It gives a nice taste to it. Now you can see from the oil and butter and raisins, you can see a little darker color in it. And that the raisins absorb that, and it gives a nice, beautiful taste And if you add that to the fried rice, it's amazing. When the raisins start to like swell up, that's when you know they're cooked. Okay. When the raisins are cooked, you can add cashew for more roastiness of for the fried rice. And you cook the cashew nut until it's a very dark, not dark, but golden color. Yeah. When the raisins and cashew nut are a nice golden color, you can add that to the already boiled sweet corn peas, carrot, with the egg and onion, and then you're gonna add the boiled rice. And then right after that, we're gonna start
those who like can use basmati rice. It will give a dry texture. I like to use long grain rice because it gives soft, moist appearance, and rather than eating a dry basmati rice, it's up to your taste. You can use whatever the rice. Then put some coriander leaves. Then leave it for a couple of minutes.
After a few minutes, the fried rice is cooked and ready. And you're going to be tasting it in a few minutes.